We have a very distinguished panel of speakers, and what I'll do is I'll just talk a little bit at the very beginning to set the stage, and then you will find that we'll have a lot to learn from the excellent speakers we have. I will talk about how this session is useful, because you know we need quite a bit at GTU as well as at many other universities to follow the best practices that have been proven to be successful, and more importantly probably to find out new methods of developing our educational system. I'll talk a little bit about the system that we have over here. In Gujarat, GTU occupies a very big part of the total system. We have about 95% of the seats in the total technology education, and therefore if we do not improve ourselves, well, there will be a problem for the whole of the state. Now, where we are today, let's try to see. These are the rankings which we had in 2011. I have only taken out the Afro-Asian part. I have not put here the American or the European part, because it will, you know, create a situation where we'll find that we are nowhere. But if you look over here, you will find these are the rankings which we have. And please remember, in 1985 it is said that we were nearly at the same level as China. We were behind Japan, but we were nearly at the same level as China. And today you can see where China is, and we'll come to India in due course of time. These are the rankings, and you will notice here that it is not only China, even Malaysia, Thailand, Saudi Arabia, they have gone ahead. We'll come afterwards. After all these, you know, Indonesia is ahead, and then we come in. We have this time IIT Delhi at 218 and IIT Bombay at 225. So the only thing is, if they can develop, if China can come up in 25 years, why we cannot? That is the question that we have to ask. Let's look at patents. Again, you will notice that top 20 universities does not have any Afro-Asian university if you count for 10 years. But look at 2011. There are three universities from Asia, from China, from Taiwan, and from South Korea. We are nowhere. But what I am trying to say is, it is not that we cannot be there, it is only this, that we are not there. Are our students not intelligent enough? They have proven their intelligence when they go out, so there is no reason why they should not be intelligent in our universities. Are our faculties not competent? We do not have good number of faculty, that is also true. And secondly, we have not really given them an opportunity to grow. Our system is such that we do not allow them to grow much. So it is not that they are not competent. In fact, if you go to the West, you will find so many Indians working as very good faculty. I can tell you from my own experience that we are second to none over there. Then the next question is, maybe we have lost innovation, the idea of innovation. We had a long history and we did do very well up to 1200. There's so many things we can talk about, you know. But is it that during the last 700 years we have lost all appetite for innovation? That is the question. Something we have done, we have not really done nothing. After independence also, we have had a green revolution, a white revolution, and many other things. Unfortunately, all the new products that you see around, they have been mostly designed by 70 crore people in Europe and America, and in Japan and South Korea. There are not many products that we have designed and the world is using. So that is where we are. So the question is, what shall we do? I think this question is best answered by the very distinguished panel that we have. So we have Professor S.K. Jain, director of our Ivy League institutions, one of them, the IIT Gandhinagar. I think he is the best man to try to answer these questions in our mind, Professor Sudhir Jain.